Something, and based on what you're going through, you just lost your praise. Meaning you don't praise God, you don't worship God, seem like all bad stuff is happening to you. Well, God had me to tell you on Wednesday night that whenever God begins to brag on you, whenever God begins to brag on you, then you can always expect the devil to attack you. That the attacks that are coming towards you are not based on anything but God, especially if you're living right and you're living holy. We got to add that in there, right? Because if you ain't living right and holy, you are inviting the adversary and you're on the adversary's territory. But if you're living right and you're living holy, amen, and you feel yourself under attack, it's simply because God is bragging on you. And whenever God brags on you, the devil is going to attack you. Amen. Maybe you were at the bottom of his list when you were doing all manners of things, but when you turn your heart over to God, when you turn your attention towards God, then the devil said, I got to turn my attention towards you. But I tell you, the devil has no victory over you. Amen. I say he has no victory over you. He has no authority over you. He has no power over you. No weapon formed against you. I'm talking to the believer. No weapon formed against you says shall prosper. That don't go for unbelievers. That only go for believers. Amen. Say no weapon. You ought to say it like you mean it. No weapon. In my marriage. In my body. Over my children. Over my finances. Formed against me. Say shall prosper. Sell more. If you're more than a comfort, you ought to act like it. If you're more than a comfort, you ought to talk like it. Amen. It ain't enough just to act like it, you ought to talk like it. Your conversation ought to be more than a comfort. Every now and then, you get intoxicated based on information and stuff come out of your mouth, but all let it keep coming out of your mouth. At some point, you ought to shake yourself. At some point, you ought to be sober and gird up the loins of your your mind and say, that's not what I'm going to talk about anymore. I'm more than a conqueror. And if the devil is attacking, I'm going to begin to attack. I'm not going to wait for him to attack. I'm going to go on the attack. Hallelujah. I'm not going to play defense. I'm playing offense. Amen. And I'm taking the fight. Say, I'm taking the fight. Take the fight to the devil. Hallelujah. Take the fight to the devil. If you don't, he'll keep bringing the fight to you. Take your harp. The harp is what they use to praise God in Zion. They got so defeated that they took those harps and hung them over the willow. In Psalms 137:2, because they didn't want to praise anymore. I tell you, praising will bring the presence of God in your situation. The Bible says that God inhabits the praises of his people. How many people of God do we have in here today? I mean, I just didn't see any. Praise God, amen. Well, I tell you what, when you begin to praise him, he inhabits your praise. He lives in your praise. He dwells in your praise. He's present in your praise. Amen. So don't allow your situation to bring you to the point where you don't praise God. Amen. Praise him when you're going through. Praise him when things are good. Praise him when things are not good. Amen. That's what true worshipers do. We praise God anyhow. I'm going to praise her. Many times I wasn't acting right. I'm sure she had to praise her. Your spouse ain't acting right? Praise her. Boy, I tell you, you begin to praise God. And all of heaven come to your rescue. Angels come to your rescue. Amen. People begin to favor you, amen, because you're praising him. Say, praise the Lord.
Praise
ye, Lord. Without expectation. You praising him thinking, well, I'm going to praise him and something will happen. No, you got to expect something to happen. You're praising him because you have an expectation. Amen. You're praising him because you have an expectation. Anybody expect something to happen? Anybody expect something to happen? You ought to be saying, I'm about to pray for this and something about to happen. Amen. 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 You better not mess with me because I know God. Amen. That ought to be your mindset. You better not come this way because God don't like nobody messing with me. God don't like anybody talking to me crazy. That's got to be the way you feel about your relationship with God. That you know God loves you so much that you are his anointed. I'm anointed. Hallelujah. Not because of your ability, but because of your availability. It ain't your ability. It's because you don't already attend at your own funeral. Anybody went to their own funeral? If you ain't, you ought to go to it. Because the Bible said, no longer I, but Christ. Well, he can't live in me when I live in me. So I need to die. Amen. Anybody going to their own funeral? Amen. If not, you ought to go to your own funeral. Amen. Say, no longer I. No longer I. Amen. I used to act this way. I used to do this, but no longer I. But Christ that lives in me. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. I want to talk about these signs. These signs. These signs. Amen. You know, we're heading towards revival and we're expecting to see signs. No, listen, let me back up. We're heading towards revival and we are going to see signs. Amen. Hallelujah. We're going towards revival, and we're going to see signs. And we're going to see wonders. And because we're children of the living God, amen. And we didn't just come, y'all didn't just come in here to hear no elegant words or persuasive words. You came to see and experience the power of God. Amen. If you're sick in your body, you ought not leave here sick, you ought to leave here healed. Amen. Amen. If you're out of fellowship with God, you ought to leave here revived and renewed. Amen. If you're in a backslidden state, you ought to, that ought to be it. Before you came in here, now you're no longer in that backslidden state. Amen. Your life is brand new right now. Amen. Praise God. If you're depressed, unhappy, you can leave all that stuff here. Amen. And I'm telling you, you can cast it on the Lord. Amen. If you broke, you ought to cast it on God. Amen. He don't want any broke children. All of his children are blessed. We're heirs. I said we're heirs. Amen. Stop looking at your account. Look at God's account. Amen. Praise God. Because he said he'll do everything according to not yours, but his riches and glory, right? But I don't want God to look at my account. I want to look at his account. I don't want God to put out of my pocket. I don't want to put out of his pocket. Amen. Praise God. God got some deep pockets. Amen. I mean, they ain't got no body to them. Amen. Amen. As far as you can reach, you can grab a hold of something. Amen. He said, the Bible says, he's our shepherd. We shall not. Some people say, God won't meet your wants, but right there, he said he will. Don't listen to people. Listen to the word of God. Amen. Says he's your father. He'll supply all your need. I like the fact that it didn't say needs, because God never expected you to have more than one at a time. Because he expected that every time you have a need, you bring it to him. He'll fill it. Then you have another need, he'll bring it. He never said he'll fulfill all your needs, plural. He said fulfill all your need according to his riches and glory. Because God said, why would you wait till they pile up and be burned down with it? He said, bring those things to me as you receive them. You get a need, you hand it to me. I'll hand it to, amen, praise God. Amen, come up here, brothers, amen, praise God. Amen, you get a need. I know, baby, you always sitting there. Amen, praise God. So you get a need, they hand it to you. Amen, they hand it to you. You just, you know, the devil over here, amen. He'll hand you something, you just hand it right to God. Amen. You see, I hand it to God, right? And that's how we do a lot of times. We hand it to God, we still got our hand on it. Because if God don't do it fast enough, I may want to take it back. But the Bible said, cast them on the Lord. And the song said, give your burdens to the Lord and leave it there. And so you have the God, you just leave it there. Because the devil going to hand you something else. And if you ain't careful, you'll be holding this, and the devil will keep handing you other stuff. But when you get a need that you can't fulfill, you hand it to the Lord. Amen. Look at, I can praise him now. When I'm burdened down, I can't praise him. Because I'm heavy, I'm burdened. Well, I think I'm smart enough to handle this, amen. Well, the one that died, I died. I don't want to handle anything. I want God to handle everything. How many of you want God to handle everything? Amen. Praise God. So that's what God wants to do. And he does it, amen. And God do things based on showing us things, amen. He show us things, amen. The Bible says, you know, everything in life, you came here this morning, and on your way here, amen, you had signs that you had to follow. You had red lights and green lights and caution lights, and you had signs that said yield, you had signs that say stop. All of our life is designed with some sort of signs. There are signs in this life, amen. There are signs in this life. The signs in this life tell us things. You can walk outside and see the clouds are somewhat full of water, and it's a sign that it's going to rain, amen? And you say, well, I need to grab my umbrella or my coat, you know, because it's going to rain. There are signs, amen? There are signs. So in this life, we are accustomed to signs. And I'm going to tell you why we're accustomed to signs, because our God is a God of signs. Our God gives us signs. Amen. He's a God that operates according to signs. And he's okay with that. He's okay with us believing and seeing signs and expecting signs. Because in his words in the book of Matthew, the 10th chapter, the 7th and 8th verse, it says this to us. It says, and as ye go, preach, saying, the kingdom of heaven is at hand. And this is what he tells us to do. Heal the sick. cleanse the lepers, raise the dead, cast out devils. Freely ye have received, freely give. He tells us to do what? Heal what? Heal the sick. That's the role of every believer in this church. It is not the role of the pastor alone, but it's the role of every believer. Say, I'm a believer. Every believer. How many believers we got here? Praise God. Hallelujah. Good to see you, Brandon. It's every believer in here. Our role and our assignment is to do what? Heal the sick. Amen. Lay hands. I tell you, at this revival service, everyone, we're giving everybody oil at the revival service. Because everybody needs to be of the mindset that when I encounter something, I need to be able to lay hands on that something. I need to be able to bless my family and bless my children. I don't have to wait till I get to church, amen. I may not see the pastor. The pastor has no more power than you. If you accept it and use the power that you have on the inside of you. Amen. Because God said there's a power that working on the inside of you. The power that's in you. The authority that has been given us by way of Jesus Christ. Amen. We have power to heal the sick. He wouldn't tell us to do something that we couldn't do. He wouldn't give us an assignment to do something that we simply cannot do. We can do it because we were created in the image and the likeness of God. Amen. It's what you're made from that allows you and gives you the ability to do it. Amen. It's who you made of. It's who you come from. We come from a God that created the heavens and the earth. A God that created man. So if God created us from himself, made us in his image and his likeness, then we have the ability to do exactly what God has done. So he says, heal the sick, cleanse the lepers, raise the dead. Amen. Raise the dead. Brother Dale showed us you can still raise the dead. Amen. That baby in his wife's belly, did he raise her? Yes. Amen. Yes. Cast out devils. Yes. Cast out devils, demons, spirits. Yes. Wickedness in people, amen. Demonic spirits, sickness and disease, cast it out. Yes. Amen. Amen. Freely you have received. Yes. Freely we give. Yes. Amen. Yes. We've been given this by Jesus Christ because we're believers, amen. How many believers we got? Amen. Praise God. Woke up the other morning, head stopped up. I took everything. You know, it's so crazy how we think, man. You know, I can lay hands on everybody but myself. Amen. I can pray for everybody but myself. And I woke up that morning and I could hardly talk. My throat was sore. My head was pressure, you know. And I knelt down to pray. Amen. And I was praying. And God said, pray for yourself. Ask me to take that pressure out of your head. And I'm telling you, God as my witness, when I asked God to do it, before I got up from my knees, listen to me, my head, no more pressure, no more sore throat, nothing. I mean, it just went like that. I was taking some medicine that would work 6 hours. It would stop me from draining and everything, and it would work the 6 hours that I took it. But then in the morning when I got up, I was stopped up in one nostril. Head was just pounding pressure. When I asked God to do it. He did it. You know why he did it? Because he's faithful. You know why he did it? Because he said he would. Because he's not a man that can lie. And because all he wants is his anointing. His power and authority to be us to be available. Say available. Available to receive it and realize it is not our ability. It is his availability. It's our availability for him. And that's what he did. He came in and he did exactly what he said he was going to do. And I'm to God be the glory. And he's no respecter of person. If you believe, he'll do the same thing. Let me tell you something. Signs and wonders should follow us. Over in the next verse, Mark, this is what it says to us. It says, and these signs. That's what we're going to talk about, these signs. And these signs shall follow. Listen to me, you got to get this today. And this is our revival. We already started revival. See, revival, we already revived ourselves. We're waiting on other folk to come. And these signs shall follow them that believe. How many believers we got here? Keep your hand up now. We got to look at your neighbor and say, you got your hand up now. Do you have signs following you? If not, you need to put your hand down. Because it said, and these signs shall follow them that believe. Man said, if you walk in snow, you can look back and see your footprints. Them signs follow you. You walk in mud, you can look back and kind of track where you was, amen? Because them tracks represent what? Signs. We lay hands on people. We ought to be able to see where we've been. It says, and these signs shall follow them that believe. How many believers we got here? Amen.
Amen.
We got to have some signs following us. When you pray over your children and pray over your situation, you got to expect to see a sign.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Come on.
You got to know that I'm about to pray about this thing. And because I'm a believer, something about to happen. I'm telling you, something about to happen. Why is it going to happen? Because I'm a believer. And signs follow me.
Amen.
I'm a believer. And because I'm a believer, signs follow me. And signs follow them that believe. In my name, say my name.
In my name.
We know that everything that we do is not in our name. But the devil do need to know your name.
Amen.
The devil need to know you. He need to know you.
Amen.
Amen. He need to know you. He need to know you. He need to know your name. When they try to cast them demons out, hey man, them devils say, hey, we know Paul. We don't know you.
Wow.
So the devil knows your name. And he knows if you believe what you say. So if you don't believe what you're saying, no signs are gonna follow. See, he knows at church. You may be lifting your hands and praising him, but at home, you're hanging your harp over the willow. You ain't praising him. You ain't worshiping. You crying. You worried. You lost your joy. You depressed because things ain't worked out. And you come to church, you trying to lay hands on somebody, and the devil said, ain't nothing about him. Ain't nothing about her. She just faking in front of all them people. She don't believe what she's doing. So no signs are going to follow. No signs are going to follow. But as a believer, I say as a believer, signs, say signs. Say signs gonna follow me. Because I believe.
I believe.
Amen. It says, in my name shall they cast out devils.
Amen.
Amen.
They shall speak with new tongues. Listen. And these signs, because God is a God of signs. God said, I'm a God of signs. I'm going to show you something. You're going to see something. You're going to see a sign. You're going to pray. You're going to see a sign that your prayer was heard. You're going to believe. You're going to see a sign that what you believe has come to pass. Because I'm a God of signs. About to see some signs. All you got to do is grab hold to it. Amen. I saw signs in this little girl right here having migraine headaches when she was 12 years old, missing school. Amen. her faith would deform. She would have migraines so bad her faith would deform. Y'all heard me tell the story. I'm going to keep telling it. We would run her up to Monroe, Louisiana, to a pediatric neurologist. In my opinion, he himself needed to see somebody. And he would give her medicine. We'd drive. He'd take him. We'd go in the office. He'd spend about 5 or 10 minutes with her. She'd come out with some medicine. We'd take her home, and she'd take that medicine, and it would make her sleep. It would make her forget. She would leave her homework. She'd leave her backpack. We later realized all of that wasn't medicine. But she would leave stuff. She would forget stuff. My wife came to me and she said, you know why? She said, Lauren is forgetting a lot. So I began to look at the side effects of this medication, and that was one of the side effects of it. I talked to a nurse about it, and she said, yeah, that's one of the side effects of that medicine. So I said, take her off of it. She said, bring her here. I put some oil on my hand. I laid my hands upon her, and I commanded that demon of migraines to leave my daughter's hand. I said, you get out of her in the name of Jesus. I spoke to that mountain.
Move.
And let me tell you what happened. That devil left.
Hallelujah.
She ain't on no medication. She ain't been on no medication. And the devil will try to come back and we continue to cast him out. Because he's hard-headed. The Bible says he leaves for a season, and we continue to cast him out. The sign that followed was no more migraines.
Amen.
No more migraines. And now she knows how to pray for herself. Amen.
Amen.
Signs and wonders follow them that believe.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Every time, not sometime, every time.
Amen.
God, say God for God the signs.
God.
Say, Lord, show me a sign.
Lord, show me a sign.
Lord said, I'll show you a sign if you believe.
Yes.
He said, all things are possible to him that
believe.
Believe. Amen. Yes. You want your body healed? You want your marriage fixed? Believe God.
Yes.
Pray for your marriage. Pray for your children. Pray for your body. Yes. Then get up and expect it to happen.
Yes.
I remember Adrian was telling me he was reading a D.L. Moody. D.L. Moody. Is an old preacher from the old days. And D.L. Moody, I remember this particular story about D.L. Moody. I don't know if I shared this with Adrian, but I remember D.L. Moody was everybody would go to D.L. Moody. They wanted D.L. Moody. D.L. Moody could pray for people and they would be healed, man. And this woman was dying, was on her deathbed. Her children sent a telegram to D.L. Moody, said, our mother is dying. Will you pray for her? Will you come and pray for her? And D.L. Moody sent a telegram back to him, said, I can't come. I'm busy. But at 4:00 this time, I am going to be praying for her. And they got that telegram. The man dropped the telegram off at their house, and they took the telegram and ran upstairs, and they read it to their mother because she believed in D.L. Moody. And they read that telegram, and it happened to be a few minutes before 4:00. So they're reading this telegram that what D.L. Moody said, Mama, D.L. Moody will be praying for you at 4:00. And the woman was watching the clock, and at 4:00 she pulled the cover back and stepped out of bed and got up, and they said, Mama, what are you doing? She said, well, D.L. Moody prayed for me. I know I'm healed. Glory! Got up off her deathbed, lived another 15 years. Because she believed that the man of God praying for her at that hour that she's supposed to get up.
Amen.
See, you know, it says, and the Holy Spirit come down and they begin. They begin. You just got to begin some stuff. It's just, when you pray, you just got to begin. You just got to begin to do. You got to begin to walk in whatever it is you believe in God for. That's when the signs come. When you believe God for something, you don't sit and wait. You believe Him for something. You get up and you just move in that direction. Amen. You believe in God for something to change, then begin to act like it. Begin to walk like it. Begin to talk like it. Amen. These signs shall follow them that believe. Because God, say God is a God of signs. He's a God of signs over. In Moses' days, when God had told Moses that he was sending him to Pharaoh to deliver the children of Israel. And Moses wanted to know, God, how are you going to do that? He said, they're not going to listen to me. And God said, what's the sign? And Moses wanted a sign. And God said, take that staff in your hand and throw it down. And he threw the staff down, and the staff that he had in his hand turned into a serpent. And he said, pick it back up again. Grabbed by the tail and picked it back up, and it was right back at his staff. But that wasn't enough for God. God said, take your hand and place it on the inside of your bosom. Pull it out again. When he pulled it out again, his hand was white, leopard white. God said, now take that same hand and place it back in your bosom. And he took it and put it back in his bosom. So now pull it back out again. He pulled it back out again, and it was healed. God is a God of signs. He is a God of signs. He called on Gideon. The angel went to Gideon and said, mighty man of valor. And Gideon was like, who is Gideon? Is the low, he's in the lowest tribe there is. And he's the weakest of them all. And he wondered, who was the angel talking to? I'm talking to you. And Gideon said, well, if you talk to me, wait here. Wait here just a little bit. And then you wait with it. And Gideon went. Got a cake and got a little gold and got some oil. And he brought that stuff back. And the angel said, put it right there. Put it on this rock. Cake and put the little kid, the little goat there. He took some oil and he poured it over. And the angel touched it. And a fire ignited. That was a sign from God. Because Gideon said, I need to see a sign. But old Gideon said, that ain't enough for me. Because God had called him to deliver the children of Israel. He said, that ain't enough. I need to see another sign. And then Gideon told God, he said, I need to see another sign. And God said, and he said, I'm going to take my fleece. And I'm going to lay this fleece out on the grass tonight. He said, God, if it's really you and you show me a sign, he said, God, cause this fleece to be wet. And the ground would be dry. So he laid it out there, went to bed, and he got up the next morning, and when he stepped out on the ground was dry. But when he got to the fleece was wet. Now our God can cause dew to fall in whatever area he wants it to fall in. And it fell just on the fleece to where the ground around the fleece was dry, but the fleece was wet. He wrung out a bowl full of water just from that fleece. That's God. And old Gideon said, well, God, that's a sign, but can you just show me one more sign? So tonight I want to leave the fleece out, and in the morning when I get up, can you let the fleece be dry and the ground be wet? Well, he got up that morning, he stepped out on the grass was wet. Can you imagine God allowing the grass to be wet?
Amen.
And the fleece to be dry? That was a sign from the Lord. Why is that? Because he is a God of signs. He's a God that shows his children signs.
Amen.
The dew had failed, and the ground was wet. And the fleece was dry. And Gideon went and did exactly what God had called him to do. With few men, he was able to deliver the children of Israel. Because with God, you don't need a whole lot. All you need is God. Amen. My last verse, the book of Luke. Is that my last one? That's two more. Come to my next one, please. Mark 6:67. And they shall take up serpents, and if they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them. They shall lay hands on the sick. Why is God telling us to lay hands on the sick? Because we're the children of God. We're children of signs. This revival that we're having, it ain't going to be no revival where we just talk to the people. It's going to be a revival where people are going to be healed. where people are going to be delivered and people are going to be set free. Aren't you tired of going to church and somebody just talking to you?
Amen.
Why you go to church for that? You can do that at home. The body of a believer is a place where people are supposed to be reformed, renewed, revived, healed, and delivered and set free. Where blind eyes are to be opened.
Amen.
Where deaf ears are to be unstopped. Amen. Where sickness and disease in your body is supposed to go. Where depression is supposed to go.
Amen.
It's a place of healing. Amen.
Amen.
And if you're on drugs, you ought to be set free. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
That's a sign. Amen. Amen. God healed anybody in here? Anybody been healed? Look at the signs. Look at all these signs. Look at all these signs. God delivered anybody off of drugs in here? Anybody got off drugs in here? Amen. Look at all the signs, amen. Praise God. Pray God fix anybody's marriage in here? Don't stand up, baby. Don't stand up. Amen. Praise God.
Amen.
Is God working on anybody's marriage in here?
Amen.
If you prayed about it, signs will follow.
Amen.
I said signs will follow. Amen. God bless anybody here financially? Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. Anybody need to be blessed financially? Amen. Amen. All you got to do is believe God.
Amen.
And these signs will follow them that believe. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. You believe God, signs are going to follow.
Amen. Amen.
If you expect them to follow.
Amen.
Praise God. Amen. Luke. Amen. It says to us, for unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign. Man, our God. He's a God of signs. You better open your eyes and see what's happening. You better open your eyes and see what God's trying to show you something. God is trying to reveal something to you. He's a God of signs. He wants to show us a sign. This time, this season that we're in, God is showing me a sign. He is showing me a sign that abounding grace, that this place right here, this place where you're sitting at, it is going to be a healing station. It is going to be a hospital for the sick. It's going to be a place for broken marriages, a place for broken hearts, a place for broken people, that people who are broken will come in here and be healed, and their hearts will be healed, and they'll be fixed. People that everybody else have forgotten about, have thrown away, consider as trash. We're going to go to the trash can and pull them out of here. We're going to go pick them out of the trash can. Somebody done threw away some perfectly good women, some perfectly good men, some perfectly good children, and we're going to go and pluck them out of that trash can. And we're going to come in here, and we're going to pray for them, and we're going to love on them, and we're going to see signs and wonders.
Amen.
Some people have been given up on because they've been so sick, amen. They've been so diseased. They've been so mentally ill for so long that people have given up on them, amen. And they have given up on themselves. And abounding grace and the believers here, we're going to be people that will not give up on people. Amen. But we're going to be people that believe God and believe that we are available. And by being available, we are anointed. And that the Jesus on the inside of us will heal, deliver, set free, make whole. Amen. We don't believe the Bible. That's what this church is. It's going to be like the Jordan River that Naaman dipped in. It's going to be, it ain't a pretty place. Everybody don't want to come to Moortown. Everybody don't want to come down Hollywood, amen. But let me tell you something. You're going to see the signs of it. You're going to see the signs of it. You're going to see the signs of it. Because people are going to come to this church of all race and all nationality. And the reason they're going to come is because they're going to hear about the signs. They're going to hear about the signs. People don't care. about where they go when their children sick.
Amen.
They don't care about where they're going when they got a bad report from the doctor. Amen. No. They don't care about where they're going when their marriage is falling apart.
Amen.
If they hear that something is happening,
yeah,
they're going to come.
Amen.
And when they come here, let me tell you what they're going to find. They're going to see the body of believers.
Yeah.
They're going to see, I don't have to get to the pastor to be healed.
Yeah.
I can just get healed by the greeter.
Yeah.
I can get healed by the parking attendant.
Yeah.
I don't have to come all the way. I don't even have to come all the way in the building to get healed.
Yeah.
Somebody on the outside got a little bottle of oil in their pocket they can pull out. And they can lay their hands on me and command sickness and disease to leave my body. And let me tell you what they're going to find. They're going to find that even if they don't have faith and you have faith, that you got enough faith to heal them. You got enough faith to deliver them. You ain't going to worry about where their faith is. You're not going to worry about what, you know, if they're a believer or not believer. Because you're going to have enough faith, enough anointing on the inside of you to lay your, you already got it, to lay your hands on them, to command demons to go, to command spirits to go, to command their mind to be right, to command him to come in their body, amen. I tell you, it's going to happen right here. Come on, give the Lord a hand of praise. With you if we got to cry with you. But we ain't going to stay right there.
Amen.
We ain't going to pity you if you're sick and diseased. We're going to heal you.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. We want your marriage fixed.
Yeah.
Praise God.
Amen.
We ain't going to tell you to leave somebody. We're going to say we're going to fix her. We're going to fix her.
Amen.
You got this all. You going to pray. It says, and this shall be a sign unto you. This shall be a sign unto you. You shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. God is a God of signs. Hallelujah. He's a God of signs. Even on your own body. You pray over your body. Sometimes, let me tell you something, sometimes you need somebody else to pray with you.
Yeah.
I came up here one night, I was sick, my neck was messed up, amen, and I had been praying over my neck, amen, and woke up, I don't know what, I had a big knot or something crooked in it or whatever. I didn't even move the wrong way, it was just the devil attacking me.
Yeah.
And I had to get the ministers up here to pray for me. Amen. I had prayed about it, but listen, I know that prayer works. So for whatever reason, if I prayed for myself and it didn't work, I'm going to find me somebody that can pray and it will work. I know God ain't lying. Amen. I prayed for them, and I'm telling you, that night, I can move my neck all the way around. I expect the devil to attack me. I expect him to try to attack me because I'm doing something for the Lord. I expect him to try to come after me because God is lifting my name up on high. He's saying, look at my boy Brian. Look at him. Look at him, y'all. Look at what's happening in Abounding Grace. Look at what's going on in Abounding Grace. And although God see what's going on in Abounding Grace, God can't come down here and help us if we don't pray. He can't protect your children and protect your finances and your interests if you don't pray. You got to do everything you're doing and still cover your family. We got to do everything we're doing and still cover each other. Amen. Because I tell you what, the devil is paying attention. The devil is paying attention. He's paying attention to who's at church today. He's paying attention. Amen. Because he wants to distract you. Because he said that hearing the word of God, the folk being told that if they're believers, signs ought to follow. Because God is a God of signs. Now, they're going to go out of here believing what they've heard.
Yes, sir.
And the devil said, I got to do something. Well, you ain't got to be afraid of that. Why be afraid of the devil? Well, he's afraid of you. Amen.
Amen.
Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death. You know the shadow is always larger than the image. The image can be this tall and the shadow is this tall. And the shadow look a lot worse than it really is. The devil's shadow look a lot worse than what it really is. I will fear no evil. God is with me. A rod and a staff comfort me. Amen. You know, the Lord got that rod that every time the shepherd would have a rod and have a little staff with a hook on it. And he had that rod. That rod wasn't for the sheep. He didn't beat the sheep with the rod because he loved the sheep. He beat the devil with the rod. He took that rod and he beat the wolves off. That rod was for the wolves. But every now and then, those sheep would be drinking a little water. And they stick their head in that water, and that wool would get saturated, and it would be about to pull them on in. And he took that hook and lifted them behind it. You know, kind of like when you get off the path of righteousness and you walk in and you about to go backwards and do some things you used to do and you about to fall in and he take that old hook. I know he used that thing on me a whole lot. Amen. And he'll lift you out of that trouble. He'll lift you out of that depression. He'll lift you out of that heartache. He'll lift you out of that drunken state. Amen. He'll lift you out of that pornography, amen. He'll lift you out of it, amen. But he won't take that rod and beat you with it because he loves you. That rod for the devil. Staff for the sheep. Tell the Lord thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
And these signs shall follow them that believe. Hallelujah. Praise God. Lost, you backslid, you turned away from God, you say, let me turn my life back to God. You've already got a sign already. You've heard enough today, and you've got to show your sign that you need to get back with God. You need to get back with God. Amen. You come and you say, I'm backslid. I've turned away from God, and I need to get back with God. And come to one of my my altar prayer. Just come and let them pray with you. Amen. Praise God. Come wherever you are. If you're sick in your body, you say, I'm sick, and I'm not supposed to be sick. I'm sick, and I got a God that can heal me. Come. You come right now. You're sick in your body. Supposed to be healed. Not going to be sick anymore. I say you're not going to be sick anymore.
Amen.
Not going to be sick any longer. Get in your mind. My body's healed in Jesus' name. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name, be healed, Sister Deborah, in the name of Jesus. Jesus, heal her body as you said you would. You said you would heal us. And I lay my hands on her. And I anoint her with this oil. And I command pain in her back and pain in her body to go in the name of Jesus. And it not to return. And that she will keep that pain out of her body. We know that the devil tries to come back. But I command this pain and this discomfort to leave her body and never to return again. That your body is healed in Jesus' name. That you can bend over. That you can run. That you can jump. That you can do whatever you want to do. That everything in your back is brand new today in the name of Jesus. Everything in your back is whole in the name of Jesus. Healed in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. God, we command Kelly's body to be healed in the name of Jesus. I called her this morning before I came out to pray with her over the phone. But I command her body to be healed, Lord. Everything to be restored in her body in the name of Jesus. Every area that the adversary has attacked, that it be healed right now in Jesus' name. Healed and made whole in the name of Jesus. Be healed, be made whole, be set free in Jesus' name. Can it be healed in Jesus' name? Amen. You touch her from the top of her head to the very sole of her feet in the name of Jesus. She's healed in the name of Jesus. Tell them to put it on that paper, to send it. They can't come, you tell them to send it, put it on that table. And God is going to heal. He's going to deliver. He's going to move on all of these requests. He's going to move on everything. Now some of you may be saying, I don't want to write down. They're going to read. Nobody's going to read what you write, but God. It's your obedience to write it down. We're going to pray over. It's going to be in this atmosphere where preaching and healing and deliverance is going to take place. And then when we pray over it, you're going to experience something. I'll tell you, this is going to be a revival, a restoration revival like none other. Amen. Amen. 6:30. At 6:30.
Amen.
Don't let the devil keep you at home. Don't let him keep you home. You'll be able to get home time enough to put your babies to sleep. But you do not want to miss what God is going to do in and through us. You do not want to miss it. I'm encouraging you about in grace. This revival don't work without you. You have got to invite every one of you. Number one, you got to be here. Those 4 days, you got to be here. It's 4-day revival, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday. You got to be here. If you come, it's going to make this revival what it's supposed to be.
Amen.
Not only if you come, but you got to bring somebody with you every night. You got to invite someone. You got to invite them with the intent for them to come. Because if you love them, if you love them, if you love them. I had a man call me from a church in this town who was in kidney failure. And we prayed for his kidney. And he came out of kidney failure. If you were on the radio last week, you heard him. But I was at a revival a couple of weeks ago, 2 or 3 weeks ago. And I walked in this church, and this man had never seen me before, and he was ushering at one of the doors. And I came in, and I opened the door at a time I shouldn't have opened. I didn't know. And he kind of had this frown look upon me. And I said, man, I'm sorry. And I walked on in and sit down. And while I was at that revival, the pastor had me to stand up. I said, that's Pastor Hollins, who's on the radio right then. I stood up. And on my way out of that church, when the revival was over, that same man stopped me and grabbed my hand with tears in his eyes and said, you prayed for me. I was in kidney failure. I didn't know that was you. I'd never met you before. I was in kidney failure, and you prayed for me, and God healed my kidneys. And that same man called in the radio station last week of last month when I was on the radio and gave that same testimony over the air. You need to bring people here to that revival. They're not coming to hear a Bible story. They're not coming to hear something they can hear somewhere else. They're coming to be healed. They're coming to be delivered. You tell them, say, you can get, if you're sick, if your marriage, if your family, whatever the case may be, if you're backslid, bring them. You already know people you can bring. Every night you need to bring 2 or 3 people, 2 or 3 families. Bring them here so this place will be packed because the Spirit of God is truly going to be here. The presence of God is going to be here. The presence of God is going to be here to heal. It's going to be here to deliver. It's going to be here to set free. The presence of God will be here in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Come on, lift your hands before we receive. Father, we thank you, Lord, for being a God of signs. We wouldn't even know what to look for had you not told us. But now we know that you are a God of signs and that signs should follow those of us who believe. And we expect them to follow. We thank you for the healing. We thank you for the baby that's having surgery, God, that everything will be well with her, Lord. We thank you, dear God, for back pain and back to discomfort going away. We devil, we command you to go in every situation. I pray a prayer that I command everybody here to be healed in Jesus' name. Everybody in this place, that some that don't even know they're sick, cancer growing in their body, I command that cancer to die out right now in the name of Jesus. You ought to tell the Lord thank you, because it could have been you. Thank you, Lord. My body is healed and made whole. No tumors, no growth in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. If you're here today and you have not Christ in your life, you say, I'm here and I have not received Jesus. And I want to receive Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior today. If you're here, I'm inviting you to come now. I'm inviting you to come now. You're here and you say, I don't have Jesus in my life. And maybe you're here and you say, I have Jesus, but I don't have a place of worship. And I need a place where I can grow. That's what I need. I need a place where I can call home. If that's you, I'm inviting you to come right now. Inviting you to come right now. You're here. You don't have a place of worship. You don't have a church. Amen. I'm inviting you to come. In Jesus' name. The Spirit of the Lord is telling you to move. Don't disobey the Spirit. Don't ignore the Spirit. Don't grieve the Spirit. Praise God. Praise God. We've already prayed for those who are sick. We've already prayed for those. Any needs that we need to pray for, we'll pray for. Praise God. Let's prepare our hearts for the ministry of giving.
Amen. Glory.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Let's receive our communion before we receive offering. Amen. Go ahead and open your communion cup. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Mount of grace. Take heed to what your pastor said today. Invite people to revival. Don't let it be somebody else's responsibility. Let it be your responsibility. You may say, what can I do? What can I do? What can I do to help in this revival? You can invite people to come. You can invite family and friends, somebody you know who's hurting, somebody you know who's in trouble. Invite them to come. The people that you think won't come are the ones that will. Invite them to come. Sunday night, it's going to be a big night. Sunday night at 6:30, it's going to be the kickoff. It's going to be a big night. I believe the beginning of a revival is the most powerful night. A lot of people said the last night, but the beginning of the revival is the most powerful night. It sets the stage, the atmosphere for that revival. Amen. We've been praying and we've been seeking God for this revival for more than a month. God's going to do some miraculous stuff here. Amen. Go ahead and hold your seat. Everybody has communion. Go ahead and hold those cups up. Amen. That bread. Amen. Listen, this bread, it's not just bread, but it's the body of Christ. It is the body of Christ. And we remember Christ Jesus on this day. His body was broken so that your body would be healed. Your body is made whole now because his was broken. This cup represents the New Testament in his blood. All of your sins, all of my sins are under his blood. They ate and drank together. Ministry. Pastor Hollis never ever talks about the giving. Because I believe in your heart that if you are obedient to God, that you're going to give without me ever saying anything about it. That when you give, you're blessed from your giving. You're not blessed from me strong-arming you, or you under the impression that I'm looking at your giving, because I don't. I don't look at it, because that's just not what God's given me to do. Amen. No brothers back there. But let me tell you something. I need an over and above offering today. Because I'm going on the radio this week for a revival. We're going to actually be live on Facebook, and we got a guy coming in to video that revival. So I'm asking for a seed, an over and above seed. How often do we do that in this church? How often do we do that in this church? Amen. So I'm asking that you would sow an over and above seed, that you would find a seed for the kickoff of our revival. Amen. That we can do some things that we need to do, that I believe I'm led to do. Amen. I'm led to do. A lot of times I don't ask. I just do it myself. And praise God, I believe God for 100% tithers in our church.
Amen.
Amen. If you're not tithing, I pray to God that you become a tither.
Amen.
Usually in a church, only 20 to 23% of the people in a church give. 20 to 23%, that's very low. Amen, but that's in every church, unfortunately. So today I'm asking you that you would find it in your heart to sow an over and above seed. That means sow something above what you've already sown on today, if you can. President, grab me the mic, please. And, you know, our church is not supposed to just be a church that pays bills, pay our mortgage and stuff like that. You know, we have got to send money other places for ministry. Amen. We always have to take seeds from here and support something foreign. Amen. Help some missionary. Help some pastor that's doing something. And we do. We do. When we have a cause and we identify that it's legit, amen, we do that. We make it our business because we want to know that our seeds that are coming in are not just going to keep the lights on or the grass cut. Same stuff that you have in your house, we have at this church. When things break, you got to get it fixed, and it costs to get it fixed. Amen. 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 We can pray over the air conditioning all we want to, but, you know, God said call somebody to fix it. Amen. Praise God. We had a unit to go out up here. Up in this city, we had a unit to go out, and our lowest bid to have this fixed was $2,500. That was the lowest bid because, you know, they would have had to get a lift to go up in there and fix it. And we said the devil is a lie. Amen. Me and Pop got a ladder. I climbed up on that ladder, and I'm telling you what I did. I climbed on that ladder, and I rigged myself up. I tied myself to them rafters up there. I hung myself to them rafters. Didn't I do it, Pop? I tied myself in, and they hoisted the tools up there, and I took that part off that the man said needed to come off, and I lowered it back down, and Pop, when it got the part only cost $108. But to get the lift in and get all that stuff in, it was $2,500. No. I learned all this stuff on the fire department, how to hang around. And I'm going to get some rope and hang up there, amen. And I hung up there, and I took that thing off, amen. It took us a couple of days to do it, but we got it done. Amen. Praise God. But I'm saying, you don't ever have to walk in and worry about the lights or the water or those things, because we don't make you worry about that. So come on, stand to your feet with that offering. Amen. Praise God. And listen, what I'm gonna do? I'm just gonna pray over the seed that you're given, and I'm gonna pray the benediction at the same time. I'm gonna have you go back to your seats. Amen. The most important thing to remember is revival this week. Be in prayer for our ministry. Be in prayer for Pastor Holins. Be in prayer for the pastors here at American Grace. Be in prayer for revival. Revival takes place when people are praying. When people are praying. God, we thank you. We thank you, Lord, for another day that you have made, a day we've not seen before, that we are rejoicing and we're glad in. We thank you, God, for the word that has gone forward, these signs. God, we look for signs, and we see signs even now. God, bless those who have the desire to give and have the finances to give. I know some desire but don't have. God, let them pray that the next time that they'll have, God, and let them even pray for this revival. But Lord, the seeds that we're receiving, God, let them be used to do something miraculous. God, if one person turned their heart to you, if one person is healed, if one person's life is changed, God, our giving was not in vain. So Father, thank you, Lord, for the heart of the believer. Thank you, dear God, for this ministry and all of these who work here and serve you. Bless us as we leave this place. But Lord, never your sight. Take us to our next destination is our prayer. In Jesus' name, amen. 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 If you just sow your seed, amen, and hear amen, and just do it in a